Hello, everyone. First, I should thank you to give us this opportunity to present our paper. As you can see, we're working on building a test set of dislocations in Persian for neural machine translation. We are working on this paper from different labs of Université Paris-Cité. Here's the outline of my presentation. I first begin with an introduction, then I would talk a little bit about the dislocation as a let's say difficult linguistic phenomenon, which is in different languages. Then I will go through some really small ideas about the language Persian or Farsi. Then I will go through the methodology of our study, our results, and the conclusion, and for sure take home message for this let's say conference. We build the whole idea is to build a test set or challenge set to observe the function of NMT toolkits or systems when it comes to some challenging linguistic phenomenon. We choose this location as a challenging construction. We've got some reasons for doing that because we think that this location is challenging because it is more alluded to spoken data, to oral data. And based on the previous study we conducted with Dr. Balier, we found out that the spoken data are often under represented in training data of neural machine translation systems when it comes to French into English. Now, what is dislocation? Here, I'll give you an example. When we've got the copy structure, for example, in the French sentence, we've got la vie c'est beau, or in the Persian, I would say man khodam means I myself. So we've got the repetition of dislocated item with usually a proform that resumes the referent of that dislocated item. About Persian or Farsi, I should say that we have two options. So for calling this language, we prefer Persian, is an Indo-Iranian branch of Indo-European family. Based on Fariri and Saint-Vélien, it's a kind of free word order. It is SOV, but the idea is that we've got a free word ordering, especially when it comes to spoken data. Persian, we can say, is still an under-resourced language for NLP tasks, as shown in the previous answer workshop. And Persian allows dislocation and also scrambling, which from the point of view of NLP task or neural machine translation task, it would be really interesting to investigate it more. And so investigating the translation of dislocated constructions would be really captivating, especially when it's from a kind of free word order language to a kind of fixed order language, such as English. The research question is that we've got two main research questions. Do we observe an a grammatical copy of the dislocated item in the translation? And is the information packaging effect of the dislocation rendered in the translation? In fact, to what extent can we Should we expect the machine to obey the syntactic adequacy or pragmatic adequacy? We will see that. Our methodology, we try to, let's say, build a kind of test set or challenge set based on the available universal dependency tree banks, which are available for Persian, Sarah G, and Rasuli. Also, we use the GrooveMatch, let's say, platform, thanks to the GrooveMatch project. As you can see here, this is the screenshot of the platform. You can easily see the relationship table, which displays relation between a governor. Here we chose dislocated because we want to extract the examples of dislocations. And in the columns, actually, you can easily choose any linguistic feature that you want. You can go for noun, pronoun, so it's really user-friendly. Regarding the detection of dislocated in a UDPI package in R, we should say that only 17 cases out of 57 sentences were detected as dislocation in UDPI package, which is not that much convincing. Regarding the NMT toolkits that we use, I should say that we try to test the different toolkits, Google Translate, MBA 50, and Microsoft Bing. Furthermore, we've got our in-house translation model that you can see the parameters of it. We train the system with TED Talks, and you can also see the distribution of training data, test data, and development data of our in-house model. The very interesting part of the research is the result of the NMT toolkits. Regarding Google, Google tries to follow the English canonical word order SVO. For example, and also it uses more dislocated constituents in the translations. For example, in this sentence, "Man khodam dar Isfahan hastam," Google goes through each word, tries to translate word by word. "I myself am in Isfahan." Regarding MBA 15, it is the same story. Outputs are close to the English word order, and the interesting thing is that it does not consider scrambling. For example, here in this sentence, "Germoro azash mutenafferam," the MBA translation is "I hate the heat," but the fact is that we, in this sentence, in this Persian sentence, we bring the object at the very beginning of the sentence in order to focus on the object. But the fact is that MBA does not consider this. Regarding Microsoft Bing, actually it also tends to copy the dislocated constituents and preserves the canonical word order like the other toolkits. We also saw some nonsense translations. For example, in this example, کتاب و سامان فرستاد. Microsoft Bing entirely deteriorates the meaning and saying someone's book sent him. We also went through Ember 50 translations in French. The copied structures from Persian are not really transferred into French. Some French outputs do not make sense, and we can see some hallucinations in the output too. And we've seen some English words in the outputs. So, when it comes to the discussion, we might ask ourselves this question that should we really expect a non-canonical word order in the translations when it comes to translation from a kind of free word order language to a fixed order language such as English? And what is we can ask this question that what is the position of syntactic adequacy and pragmatic adequacy? The thing is that the reality is that we should also take into consideration the importance of information packaging, because by just changing the word order, we want to let's say convey a kind of message to our addressee, whether to for example, introduce a topic, to reintroduce a topic, or to, for example, try to focus on one specific linguistic segment in a sentence. So we might ask ourselves these kinds of questions. Regarding the conclusion, if I want to go really quickly through what we understand from this research, we can say that no agrammatical copy of dislocated items. We haven't seen any of them in the outputs. Toolkits, as we saw, tends to preserve the canonical structure of English sentence. Information packaging of the source text is partially considered. And actually, in some cases, this kind of the change of information packaging might change the meaning of the sentence. And it may not convey the core meaning of the speaker to the addressee. So, for the further study, we can just expand our test sets, because for this study we've got only 57 examples, so we might expand this using other challenging structures such as each cleft structure, pseudo cleft structure, and we can include some cases of local scrambling, long distance scrambling in our challenge sets. Take home message. We can actually expand the training data of the NMT toolkits. So it is really important to enrich the training data of NMT toolkits with both spoken and written data. To get some convincing outputs. And for sure, being generous in sharing, okay, we all of these the test sets and also MBAF translations together with the reference translations along with their blow scores are all available in the GitHub of expect Spectrum's project, and you can just check it if you wish. I should actually thank a graduate school of linguistics of Université Paris Cité. I should also thank me a scholarship that helped me come to France to continue my studies. And I should actually thanks for the continuous help from Spectrum's project. These are the main references of our study. These are 3 ways of saying thank you in Persian. Merci, ممنون, متشکرم. Thank you very much.